Hello. Today we are going to discuss the constitutional measures taken by the Palestinian Authority to stop the spread of coronavirus in Palestine. On the 5th of March, the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas issued a presidential decree stating that Palestine will go under 30 days of a state of emergency in order to protect lives and to stop the spread of coronavirus. And in order to make sure that measures will be taken correctly, delegations were given to the Prime Minister to take any decisions necessary to maintain a good situation. The Prime Minister started issuing decisions. The first of them was to close totally Bethlehem, the first infected Palestinian city. Another decision was to stop the movement or to restrict the movement between the Palestinian cities. Education, economy, and normal life face different challenges. E-learning became the most talked about during this crisis, as universities and schools applied it immediately. The Palestinian Authority faced two major problems. One of them was how to close the border with Jordan and how to stop the Palestinians or visitors coming to the Palestinian territories, knowing that the Palestinian Authority has little control over the border. Jordan went through a state of emergency itself, and that helped a lot in controlling the movement between Palestinians coming from Jordan to Palestine, using Jordan as a passage due to the fact that Jordan has the airport that Palestinians come through. The second issue was with the Palestinian workers and how to maintain their movement in and out, and how actually ask them only to stay at home, where economy in Palestine was under question due to the fact it's very, very small economy and relies a lot on international donations, international help, international aid. So small businesses were totally affected by such decision. But Palestinians were quite eager to hear the government summary every day at 11 o'clock. The summary was giving the situation about coronavirus, how many cases, how many recovery situations we have, etc.
Trust and popularity of the government made any decision, even extending the state of emergency without legal support, a possibility.
Closing to the end of the 30 days, the government started wondering how they can extend the situation for another 30 days. And here is the interesting part about the constitutional arrangements. When the Palestinian president issued the presidential decree, he relied on Article 110, as you can see on the screen. Article 110 in the Basic Law, which is the temporary constitution for the Palestinian Authority, indicates clearly that for the first 30 days, it's totally the right of the president to issue a state of emergency. However, after the second, or if we want to go through another 30 days and extend the situation, a vote of two-thirds majority of the Palestinian Legislative Council has to take place. This is quite tricky, because in 2007, when Hamas-Fatah clash took place, a state of emergency was declared, and the Palestinian Parliament, or the Palestinian Legislative Council, got suspended from 2007 until 2018. The 30 days that were declared at the time was replaced in 2007 with another article within the same basic law, as you can see on the screen. It's the state of necessity, Article 43, where the president has the absolute right to issue decrees with the power of law. From 2007 to 2020 until now, Palestine was under Article 43. So, in 2018, actually, the suspended parliament got dissolved by the Constitutional Court. The Constitutional Court dissolved the parliament, or the Palestinian Legislative Council, and asked the president to call for elections within 6 months of the decision, or the interpretation that the court gave. Unfortunately, the elections did not take place due to different political circumstances. One of them, that reconciliation between Hamas and Fatah did not take place. Secondly, the Israeli restrictions on Palestinians living in East Jerusalem and the fact that those Palestinians will not be able to participate in any elections. Therefore, the Palestinian Authority declared that elections without East Jerusalem will never take place. This is a very, very controversial, complicated situation. There is a balance that has to be taken between protecting lives and between respecting the articles within the basic law.
I was one of the academics that wanted to strike the balance between protecting lives and respecting the constitutional articles. As expected, the articles within the basic law related to the use of emergency powers have a precise and specific stipulations. The emergency extension requires the presidential decree to obtain the approval of 2/3 of the Legislative Council, as we can see on the screen, and to declare the emergency purpose and to define the territories in which it applies. However, due to the political circumstances, the council was already dissolved by the Constitutional Court. The opinion at the time was that due to the absence of a legislative council, the president should be allowed to extend the state of emergency from a mandated 30 days for the first time into another term of 30 days. And to accomplish this, the president should transfer the position from a state of emergency into a state of necessity. I was against this argument because the condition in Article 43 is unclear. Whether the period defined, as we can see in the screen, not in session, refers only to the period when the council is ordinary, not in session, or it could also be possibly referred to extraordinary reasons for the Legislative Council not being in operation. In both cases, there should be an existing Legislative Council, which is not in session. But after the dissolution of the Council, I would argue that this condition is no longer applicable. We can see the track of a state of emergency, a state of necessity, and a state of exception on the screen. I argued that Palestine has become under a state of exception in 2018. Which is a condition, not an action. But this condition could be terminated when the president calls for legislative elections. Therefore, giving the president the authority mentioned in Article 43 after 2018 means that the exceptional legislative tool will be now the absolute norm. It also means that the president will no longer worry about calling for legislative elections, or maybe he will start issuing laws instead of decisions with the power of laws. Another opinion was granting an extension by turning the matter for another legislative body, which is the Palestinian Organization's legislative arm, the National Council, which considers the umbrella for the Legislative Council and the Palestinian Authority in general, as can be seen from the preamble of the Basic Law. This solution is not practical in this particular matter, for reasons that I won't go through, despite the legitimacy of such solution if needed. The only option, in my opinion, was for the president to issue a presidential decree, which is a tool given to him by the basic law in normal situations. He should refer to the exceptional condition, which is coronavirus, and the need to make a balance between protecting lives and the lack of a parliament that could grant an extension for the state of emergency. And he could also, through this presidential decree, issue certain measures, but such measures should go through the review of the Constitutional Court, which has the right to do so, as can be seen on the screen.
The president issued another presidential decree. Relying on a presidential decree to extend the state of emergency would have been acceptable if the president did not follow this presidential decree with a decision that has the power of law, according to Article 43. The decision with the power of law clarified that an approval is granted to this extension, which means that the president in this case replaced the Legislative Council totally. This leads us to another question. What was the role of the Constitutional Court? Why the Constitutional Court was not consulted? Wouldn't have been a different approach if the government consulted the Constitutional Court and then the extension came from the Constitutional Court? But again, the basic law was silent in such matters. It was quite a constitutional dilemma. A state of emergency was needed for the third time. But it was impossible to issue another presidential decree. If we look again to Article 110, it does not show how to give another 30 days of extension after the second time. One of the academic opinions was to stop the state of emergency for 24 hours and then issue another presidential decree. And that means that the state of emergency is fresh, is new, and then the government will have another 30 days from scratch. This is quite bizarre, because if you are using the same circumstances, why would you stop the state of emergency for 24 hours? Can shops be open for 24 hours? Can normal life be back for 24 hours? Then again, a state of emergency will be in place and people will go under curfew, etc., etc., etc. And the government declared that the state of emergency is finished for 24 hours. After the 24 hours, another presidential decree took place, indicating that Palestine will go under a state of emergency for another 30 days. After everything that have been discussed, a few things have to be mentioned. First of all, the Palestinian Authority relied on the Basic Law, which is a temporary constitution that was written by the first Palestinian Legislative Council in 1997. This Basic Law was written for a temporary period that should ended or should have ended in 1999, but the Basic Law itself was enforced or put in force in 2002. This document was not designed to face such a crisis. It was only designed for only one parliament. And it did not give options. At the time of creating or drafting the Palestinian Basic Law, the Constitutional Court was not created. No options was given. A state of emergency article was drafted in a very, very classical way. So this is the first observation. The second thing, when the Palestinian president declared that delegation will be given to the prime minister and the prime minister is the one that has to issue decrees, taking measures, etc., etc., the Basic Law does not clarify the relationship between the president and the prime minister. It's true, Palestine has a semi-presidential system and that was imposed on the Palestinian in 2003. And it caused so many problems that I won't go through it in this particular video. But this gives us an insight about the need for a clear relationship between the prime minister and the president. When many people objected the extension of the state of emergency, it was not clear to whom this objection should be addressed, to the prime minister or the president. Who is actually the true head of the government? Is it the president or the prime minister? If you want legislative life to go back as normal, elections should take place. But how can elections take place in a complicated situation? What kind of constitutional arrangements or constitutional documents should we rely on? Should we rely on the Palestinian Basic Law? The Basic Law itself cannot serve for the next stage. It was only drafted for a Palestinian Authority, not for a state. Secondly, can we ask for the draft constitution to put in place for discussion? And now, how can we do so? How can we make sure that there is public participation and transparency? With all that said, we should also point out that Palestine is still under Israeli occupation. Now the Palestinian Authority is facing even more land annexation from Israel. This situation is not an easy one for the Palestinian Authority, taking into consideration both the pressures of protecting Palestinian lives from corona and from the illegal Israeli annexations. There are so many constitutional questions that are raised during this period. I hope that was enough a brief about the situation in Palestine. And for any question, I will be very happy to answer them via emails or via the blog. Thank you.